Good morning, everyone. Today we have several news for you. Today we are presenting a special report about pollution.
Okay. Hi, Andy. In order to start with the reportage, first you need to know what is pollution. Pollution occurs when certain contaminants, such as garbage, chemicals, toxic substances, and many others, are released in the environment, affecting it and living beings.
Pollution has existed in North Korea since the beginning of the 20th century. As hunger and drought struck at the beginning of this decade, while deforestation, land erosion, pillaging of forests, water supply contamination and pollution accelerated.
E-waste production has been increasing rapidly. In 2010, the generation of e-waste was almost 10,000. These being TVs, refrigerators, washing machines, and computers' most discarded products.
Nowadays, we don't have specific information about North Korea's pollution, but we can imagine that it is serious because they haven't improved their technology, like green technology, and without it, pollution increases.
In China, pollution is one of the main problems that Chinese people have to deal with every day. Several companies have contributed to it by releasing different gases and chemicals into the atmosphere without caring about the environment.
But the companies do several things without caring if they damage the environment, just thinking in getting money in a higher place in marketing and commerce.
According to the Wall Street Journal, in China the responsibility is from everybody, people, government, enterprises, because all of these are not taking care of the environment.
Pollution is a conflict based on the struggle for resources and power due to industrial competitiveness. The conflict relation will be company-consumer because the higher the demand is, the higher the production and the higher is the pollution.
For maintaining the economic growth, China and North Korea must have continuous development and improvement in their products and services in order to keep their clients buying. On the other hand, migration has large causes, one of them being pollution, because no one really wants to live in a contaminated place for the center of life.
We have made some questions to the students of Campus Santa Fe.
Okay, first question. In general, do you think migration is beneficial and for whom? I don't think it's beneficial in general. I think it actually all depends if the country is willing to accept these people migrating and if they have the adequate conditions to accept them. If so, I think it could bring new ideas, innovation, and a different view to the country. It can